What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Bugs back, and how we doing today, guys? We got a great video for you today. And as per usual, before I say it, just drop 10k in the comments, like the vid, sub if you are new, and you can also follow me on social media, Twitter and the gram. Thanks for the support, guys. The support has been unbelievable. We've been getting like at least 10 subs a day. Man, I've been putting out 2 videos a day, and honestly, I've been seeing the results, so I'm gonna keep it coming, man. Someday I want to try to have a nice gameplay for you. We'll see how it goes, but yeah, maybe a little budget squad gameplay. But yeah, this video is nice and simple. It's just gonna be like an overview of what to not do, pretty much who to invest in and why you should not invest right now. And I'm gonna go over a bunch of players that I talked about, my roster update opinions and budget tips, all that stuff. For some reason my controller turned off, don't know why, it's not even dead. So okay, guys, this is what I'm going to tell you. So to start off this video, I'm just going to say, do not invest now. And I'm going to show you why there's so many players that you should just not invest in. There's just so many. Because right now, the auction's sort of at its peak. You're not going to see your players go up like this much unless it's like Friday morning. They might go up even more Friday morning before the update. But I'm going to go over a bunch of players I was talking about in my last video. If you didn't see my roster update predictions, this pretty much has to do a lot. This is what it has to do with. So, okay, let's get into it. We're going to start with Christian Yelich, okay? Because Christian Yelich is mad expensive. He's 56K, and you're going to see him keep rising probably till Friday, especially if his edge is up. I have one of him. I got him for 45K on the roster, on the market crash Friday last week. I'm keeping him. What I'm going to do, we're going to see how this plans out, but I'm pretty sure his price will even go up to maybe 60, 65K. So I'm going to hold on to him probably till tonight or Friday morning. We're going to see how it goes on Friday morning. Stay tuned for a video as well, how to prepare for the roster update. So do not invest in players right now. We're going to keep going. Machado, like I said, is on a tear. He's almost at 60K. Unbelievable. Do not get him. I think he's going to go up an overall though, but for 57K, I saw him for 40K literally 2 weeks ago. 40K. And last week, he was about 45K. So, not a good investment. Do not invest in him. We're just going to go over all the players where I think it's going to go down. Okay. So, pretty much, Freeman's about 40K already. He's expensive. Everyone thinks he's going to go up an overall. I think so, too. Not a good investment. We're just going to go over all the players who I think is going to pretty much get upgraded and just not to invest in them, pretty much. So we got Bellinger, Nagavest, and Votto. Okay, if you have Votto, he has a very good chance of going gold. He just hit a home run yesterday, but I really don't think, like, I don't know, man. It's really, it's looking like he's not doing good. I think he's batting 190. Stay away from Votto. If you have him, try to sell him. He might go gold. I don't know, but he might. It's a might. I don't know yet, but let's keep going. So Garrett Colson pitching well. This is one of the only good investments I could tell you to do. For 11K, honestly, he's pretty nasty anyways, and I think it's a good investment overall. So that's one of the cards that you should invest in. Chris Bryant, okay, if you could get him for 20K, I would say it's a good investment. If you can't, if you would get him for 21K, that's okay. Anything more than, I would say, 21K is just not a good investment. In my opinion, I really think he's going to get upgraded. He's been playing amazing. He had a slow start to the season, starting to spring up. I'm thinking his power versus righty goes up. His vision goes up. He's been playing awesome. He's been hitting average. He's been doing good. So hopefully he keeps that up. Okay, this is a big one. Javier Baez. Okay, what I'm thinking is Javier Baez is going to go up in price. First of all, he's been playing unbelievable. He's going to go up in price 100%. Almost. Okay, so what I'm going to tell you to do, if you have him, wait. I'm going to wait till Friday at 12 Eastern. That's when I think the prices are going to be at its peak, 3 hours before the roster update when I drop my video. So if you have him, kudos to you. You're going to make mad stubs. If you listen to me about last week, I told him to use 31K on the auction. If you picked him up, you're going to make mad stubs, maybe 15 to 20K off him. So that's lit. We're going to go to one player that I'm going to tell you to invest in. I'm just gonna tell you right now, Charlie Blackmon, he's gonna get upgraded. There's no way he doesn't get upgraded. If he doesn't get upgraded, this game is rigged. Just first of all, he's not that bad at fielding. His fielding should upgrade it. His power should definitely get upgraded. He's on a freaking home run tear right now. I'm pretty sure he has 4 in the last 3 days. You need to pick him up, okay? This is one of the only players I could tell you to invest in. I have 10. I'm going to invest more in him right now. But yeah, guys, he's going to go up in overall. He might not go up a lot in stubs, but it's a good stash. Charlie Blackman's been good for 5 years, 10, like five, 8 to 5. I don't even know. How long has he been in the league? Like 7 years? He's been good since what? 2011, 2012? I don't know. I could be off, but I remember having him in fantasy about 7 years ago, and he was a complete beast. So he's been good for a long time. Okay, let's get into Okuna. A lot of people think he's going diamond. I don't see it. If you have Okuna, I'm pretty sure I have six. I have six. I got him for 5K. If you listen to me, he was 5K. I said pick up as many as you can. He's going to be like 8 to 9K. People really think he's going diamond. I don't see it. I really don't see it. I'm going to probably sell five and keep one just in case he goes diamond. But his price is going to be too expensive to maintain. I do not think he's going diamond. He has not been playing good. It's upsetting to see, but like he hasn't. He really hasn't been playing good. So, okay, let's get into story. Now, 3,200 stubs is kind of a snag for him. You could get him for cheaper on Friday, but if he goes up in overall, one overall even, which I think he might, he's been playing pretty good. He's top 50 over the last 14 days. Not terrible. Well, I think he gets an upgrade, maybe vision-wise. His average isn't bad, but we'll see how that goes. Right now, I would say you could invest in him. There's really no downside to investing right now. For 2,900 stubs, try to get him under 3K. You should make some stubs. I really think he has a chance of going diamond. First of all, he's a budget beast. But yeah, I think that's a good investment. Let's keep going, though. We got a bunch of people we talked about. We're going to get into Silvers too. Okay, Ozuna is a good investment, actually. Like, 1K for Ozuna on 83 is very, very interesting. Especially if he goes up to an 84. He might jump 2K. Let's just get into my main man. Okay, Trevor Bauer also. Great time to invest. For some reason, a lot of these 83s are cheap. And they're really the only people that I could tell you to invest in. Other than that, I wouldn't invest in anybody else. So Trevor Bauer is a good time to invest in. We're going to talk about Kirby Yates is a good time to invest in. A lot of these 83s, 82s are good players to invest in, but some of them are overpriced. Whit Merrifield for 1,300 stubs is a snag. So pretty much, I'm going to tell you right now, bronze, silvers, and diamonds are just a no-no for investments. Only really some of the golds. The ones that I'm going over are good times to invest in. Donaldson is not a good player to invest in. I don't know. I'm not feeling it. Okay, George Springer. You know, what I'm thinking he goes up two overalls. He is the best player in baseball over the last 2 weeks. He's going to get upgraded. There's no way he doesn't. Possibly to an 84. I don't know if they'll upgrade him to a diamond. Probably not. But I'm thinking 84 overall right before diamond. To be honest, 4K is a little expensive. Even though he's probably going to get upgraded to an 84... If you want to take the chance, I bought him at 3K, 2K, and 1K. If you want to take the chance of 4,300 stubs, that's all you. That is not my problem. It's not a bad price, though, because you could still make stubs no matter what. But honestly, he's not a bad investment. He's probably going to go up in overall. I think he's going to go up in price, too. Honestly, you could pick him up for 4,300. It's all up to you, though. Zach Greinke is a great investment. I have two. 1,300 stubs, you can't go wrong. I can see him going diamond. Vlad Jr., guys, just stay away from this card. You can't predict a rookie. Like, he's unbelievable, but I just would stay away from him. He's an 82. Do I see him going diamond this year? After that 2-1 performance, possibly. But 4K right now is too expensive. He's not getting an upgrade. You can maybe pick him up. Maybe he'll go down to 2K on Friday. We'll see. But yeah, we got... Okay, hold on. I didn't even talk about this guy. Alderton Simmons has been batting unbelievable. I really think, oh my god, oh wow, so people think he's going diamond again, and I think so too, because I got him for 1,500 stubs. He's at 5k, I'm gonna make 15 after reduction, about 12k stubs. So if you listen to me about a week or two ago, I'll pick him up. So yeah, let's get into some silvers and bronzes. Let's talk about some bronzes. Okay, Devers has been on a tear. He's getting upgraded. There's no way he doesn't. For this price, stay away. Even if he turns silver, he's not going to go up a lot. Like, if you have him, you're lit. You can sell him tomorrow, the next day, right before the roster update. You'll be lit. You'll make some stubs. We got Martin Perez. I'm going to go over a couple guys. all like comments and stuff. So we got Martin Perez, 60 stubs. He went up a little bit. You could invest him at 20 stubs. Honestly, I have 30. Good player to invest in. Hunter Dozier is still doing good. Yesterday, he did amazing again. Hunter Dozier, if you have him, I would sell him. He might drop to 100 stubs again on Friday like he did last week. Great time to invest in him on Friday. Do not invest in him now. So pretty much what I'm saying is a lot of the golds are investable. Diamonds, silvers, and bronze are not. And we're going to go over one more guy, and I'm pretty sure his name is Matt or Mike Soroka. I don't know how to spell it. Oh, boy. Mike. Let's just go Mike. Let's see. Mike. So there he is. Okay. Think about this right now. A common for almost 200 stubs. No, don't. Just don't invest in him. Whoever invested in Soroka, I have none. Whoever invested him when he was a common at like 5 stubs, you're lit. Do not invest in him now. These are players you need to stay away from. I'm just putting this out there. Honestly, let's go to Chris Paddock as well. Chris Paddock is another player. I can tell you, just don't invest. He's going to be a gold. He's amazing. Chris Paddock's stats are literally Cy Young stats. But he's not going to be a gold. He cannot be turned a gold anytime soon. Maybe in a month. But if you invest him at 786, you could. 786 is not bad, but you're going to have to wait on that. I would stay away from him. He was 1,800 stubs a little bit ago. You're probably going to see him rise. But no, I would not say it's a good time to pick him up. Maybe on Friday, but yeah. Okay, guys, that's all I got for you today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you understand what I'm saying, if you don't, hit me up in the comments. It's just a little video, a little tip video for you guys, and that's all I got for you. I hope you enjoyed. Team Bugs has been killing it. Let's keep it up, baby. Let's get to 600 subs this week. Let's do it. I believe. And that's all I got. Hey, yo, good job, first.